Okay, so in this last video, I'll show you how to find distance from first year dorm. And the idea is that we're gonna have this layer as our input, and remember that the length of a cell here is 1,000 meters. And what we'd like to do is use a tool that's gonna take this as an input and give us a new output where each cell here would have a value that represents the distance from this location to the nearest cell in this layer that represents the dorm. Is that fair? So again, what we'd like to do is use a tool that for every cell in the output, it's going to calculate a value where the value represents the distance from that location to the nearest cell in the input layer that has a value that represents the dorm. That's ideally what we'd like. So we're going to use a tool called Euclidean distance to try to do this. But the problem is, if we just took this input, this Boolean raster of ones and zeros, and put it into Euclidean distance, I think our output is gonna look like this. Just a big bunch of nothing is what it'll look like. And the reason is that what this tool does, and let's see if I can just write this. For each cell in output, Euclidean distance will calculate the distance to the nearest cell in the input with a value. And that is the rub, is that for Euclidean distance, it doesn't matter if that value is 0 or 1 or 2 or 3 or anything. If there is a number in a cell, it's going to think of it as being occupied, and the output is going to be the output is going to calculate the distance to any cell that has a value as 0. I'm not sure if I'm helping it with the last part, but because you may be wondering, like, well, what the heck's the option? And the option is to store values in this raster. I'm sorry. The option is to put something in these cells other than a value, which sounds probably pretty strange. But what we'd like to do is create a raster that has ones here, like this one, but in every non-one, we have a value for no data. See where I'm going? Is it okay if I just write ND? Right? So now if we calculated the distance with this as our input, we're going to get something that we actually are happier with. So which do you want me to do first? Do you want me to tell you how we get to here before I show you this? Or should I just complete this thought? How about I complete this thought so we can pair these two and then move on? So what do you think the value is going to be here? How far away is this cell to the distance to the nearest cell in input with a value? So this one has no data, and the nearest location is now 1, right there, sorry. And so this distance from here to here is basically the same as the side of the cell, and the side of the cell is 1,000. So this guy right here is going to be 1,000 meters. Is that fair? Now here's for the fun part. What do you think goes in here? So the distance to the nearest cell and the input with the value. Well, what's the nearest cell with a value from this cell? It is that cell, right? And so that's going to get a 0, because this cell is 0 distance from the dorm, right? This cell will also get a 0. This cell will get 1,000, just like that one, because we are 1 cell size in length from the center of this cell to the center of this. Is that okay? So let's fill this out by just kind of doing the easy ones. What do you think goes there? What do you think goes here? So now if we're 2 cells away, three cells away, 4 cells away. Fair? So now, what do you think goes in here? Well, one way to do it would be if we have 1,000 and 1,000, and that's a right angle, we can use Pythag, right, to figure that out. And I think that would be, is that right? So, and then down here, it's the same thing. So then this so again, using Pythag, it's like that. This is going to be 3 by 1, which that hypotenuse I think would be something like that. And then this would be 4 by 1, and that hypotenuse I think would be that. Does that make sense? So do you see how this got us this, but if we take away the zeros so that these guys are no data, then we have these guys behave just like these guys did, but all of these can now get filled in from with values. So maybe, you know, for each cell in output, calculate distance to nearest cell and the input with a value for each cell with no data. Is kind of the idea, but even if it doesn't have no data, it's still going to figure it out. So that's even not quite right. So the idea is that what you want to do is convert or reclassify all of the locations that you want to measure kind of the distance to, rather than the distance from, if that makes sense, as no data, and leave behind all of the cells that you want to measure the distance from. Does that make sense? So that you get your from to relationship, from a value to a no data. Yeah, so sorry, I'm trying to help, but anyway, it's a little tricky. So then how do you go from here to here? Well, we're gonna use a tool called reclass. And what reclass, actually I think in ARC it's called reclassify. And what reclassify does is it allows you to set up a table where the table is gonna say something like old values, I think. And then you wanna create new values. And maybe another way is to say that these are the input values and these are the output values. And in this reclassifying table, you basically, to get this, you would say anything that is zero is going to go to no data. And then the idea is that you could leave everything else blank, because if you leave it blank, the original values here are just going to slip through. Is that fair? So I'll talk about this again, because we're going to use this again in the future. But we basically are going to use the reclassify tool with this as an input, parameterize it like this, where you are going to ask the zero values in the input to become no data, and anything else in the input you're going to leave alone, so that what you get over here is a setup where the ones are left alone and all the places that were zero go to no data, and now you can use this input in your Euclidean distance. So the last thing I'm going to say about this is that you don't always have to do this two-step in order to calculate distance from an input. You want to basically first see if your background values are being stored as zeros. And if your background values are being stored as zero, then you're going to need to remove them as no data in order to calculate the distance from your foreground feature to all of your background locations. However, if you have a raster where the background values are stored as no data, you can just go right to Euclidean distance. Is that okay?